There's not a ton of maintenance to do because stuff doesn't really progress when I'm doing side quests, but I do have more experience to spend. So this will more or less be our one stop, probably today. What do I do? I could level up the engineers, but I also often just don't use them. there's definitely benefits to leveling up scouts. And lancers are the only are getting more and more useful as more and more large tank encounters. I guess I'll do the engineer next. Whenever a big tank encounter happens, I'm like, alright, lancers, time for you to do your job. But, that mostly comes down to the fact that they're starting to more and more often create a situation where I can't use my tank in that situation. So the reduced CP cost of a... Ooh, we learned antidote. This order cures one ally of negative status. Interesting. Definitely a benefit to the having lancers that they only use one CP to move, and they can often access certain locations, because some of these more recent maps are definitely starting to hit me with locations where it's either not... Either I can't get Welkin there because there's some kind of block, or in some cases it's just not safe to move Welkin around because so many lancers are on the field that he will get one shot and then I'll fail the entire mission. So lancers definitely are getting a little more useful, but still, in many situations the tank's just the safer bet. Mostly because of the fact that if I use the tank, he can just plow straight through enemy lines, ignore all interception fire, and just shoot something in the back. But lancers have their purpose, and I want them to be ready when that purpose comes, whether it's contrived or not. So, it's time for chapter 15, at long last. It's been a while since we did another chapter, because they gave us all those new missions all at once. But we're just Citadel... Ghirlandaio? Ghirlandaio. Good luck, that's... a hell of a thing to try to pronounce. To fell a citadel. This will be a double combat chapter.
Thanks to the victory at Nagyar, our forces have pushed the enemy back to the border. The Imperials are currently holed up in the citadel at Ghirlandaio.
Ghirlandaio.
A crucial checkpoint along the commerce routes tying Gallia to the east since medieval times, the pass at Ghirlandaio had been fortified for ages. The existing structure was rebuilt as a modern fortress during the First European War, and its grounds were littered with the casualties of war. In the current war, it housed the Empire's command center, and now it stood as their final stronghold.
What's our strategy for attacking the Citadel, Captain?
I still haven't received any details on our orders from above yet.
Oh, stop your worrying, Varat! I came here myself to give you your orders!
General Damon, I'm honored, but why not just send a messenger?
Your regiment really showed him up out there at Nagyar. In return, I'm granting you the honor of assaulting the Citadel at the van of the army.
Sir?
Here are your orders. There's a supply line running into the Citadel. We're sending a train car loaded down with explosives along it to blow us an entrance. The militia will run along the track ahead of it, flipping the right rail switches.
Flipping rail switches, sir? This while dodging a hailstorm of bullets? That sounds like a suicide mission, sir.
What are you talking about? It's the perfect challenge for your fearless crew. If we succeed here, the Empire will finally be forced out of Gallia for good. You'll pave the way for the real army. You got that, Varat?
Damn it. Another mission they don't have the guts to do themselves.
Who are you?
Maybe. But it's a mission that somebody still needs to do.
Precisely. As the general said, if we win, the Empire will be driven out of Gallia. Let this be our final battle. I'll await good news from the field. Dismissed.
It's a minor note, but it just feels like the first and last time a Gallian soldier ever spoke, so I'm like, who is this guy? He even has like a... He's not even like... usually when you encounter people, it's just some guy in a helmet talking, like, that's the generic NPC. That guy's got a whole appearance and everything, it almost feels like he was supposed to be a character, but they cut him out of the entire script except for that one scene or something. The cruelest order. Gotta reestablish that the bad guys are bad.
Your Grace.
That incident grows old and stale.
Silvaria, what news have you from the front?
Sire, they seek to push our soldiers past the border, and the total of their forces approach those of our own.
I see. The advantage now begins to sway towards the other side. It seems the loss at Nagyar has ended our hopes of strolling through the gates of Rondkreese.
The fault lies with me. This would be over had I but won at Nagyar. Your Grace, grant me another chance, I beg you. Please allow me to fight for your glory, sire.
Dear Silvaria, do you truly wish to be of help?
Yes, more than anything. From the time you saved me, Your Grace, I've known that I love you more than I do my own life. Sire, I want to work in the service of your dreams.
Very well. So, Silvaria, you report that the strength of our opponent now matches our own. In that case, let the fire of destruction rain down upon them. Use the final flame of the Valkyria.
But... Your Grace!
The hour of your death shall mark the inauguration of our rule. Farewell, Silvaria.
Can't say I'm impressed, Your Grace. Making a lady cry?
The director's all like... Oh yeah, we just talked about her killing herself. We better have to get this close-up of her boob jiggle. Oh yeah. It's like she's probably about to die, right? Like, it seems a little out of touch with the context. That said, she's kind of right. It is her fault that they lost, because she was obliterating my army with her crazy Valkyrie powers, and then I grabbed a flag. So she's like, oh, I guess we'll leave now, because of the logic of the game. Like, that's, you grab a flag and you win the war, but it's like, she was still an invincible super god that was obliterating everybody. Whoops. Still, it's dark, so it seems that they must be the final flame of the Valkyrie must indicate that, like, you must somehow extinguish yourself, but also probably unleash some great power. I don't know if they'll go the route of exploding her, like a World War II, like atom bomb parallel, or if she'll just become so powerful that she can obliterate any, like, that she can defeat anything, but then she'll die afterwards from exhaustion or whatever because she uses up her power. We'll have to see.
This is simply one of a number of scenarios we'd planned for since before Nagyar. If her prowess as a Valkyria is insufficient, Selvaria's uses quickly narrow to one alone.
Anyway, there's a messenger here for you straight from Castle Randgreese.
So there is. Let him wait. I have no time for simple messengers now.
This guy's probably gonna lose the war, and he pretty much deserves it. He's just kinda stupid, in all honesty. Like, oh wow, I got a super soldier that's completely unlike anybody else in the field. Oh wait, she's not quite winning the war single-handedly? I better get rid of her now. She's clearly useless to me. What, like as opposed to every other soldier you have, you idiot?
We are set to commence Operation Steel Scythe. Jaeger, prepare to return back east.
What? Then it's... the Marmota's finished?
It is. Word has come that it has completed its trial run. The Gallians are hasty to assume victory. We shall see them gutted yet.
I'm sorry.
It's hard to see why she's so loyal to him. We kind of got some explanation about how she kind of owes him and stuff like that, but he's so ruthlessly cruel that it's hard to really follow through with that kind of thing. Bracing for battle.
Is everybody here?
No. Still no Alicia, boss.
Right. Well, let's start.
I already heard from another squad. We're prepping some tracks for a bomb.
That's right. It's a rough one, but this is a critical mission.
This is the militia. We're used to getting all the bum missions by now. With that settled, there's one question I gotta ask you, boss. Alicia's Valkyria powers and all. You plan to use those this time, too?
No, Largo, of course I don't. I have faith in your natural abilities. Who needs Valkyrur when I've got you all?
Good answer. I'd expect no less from you, boss.
We're ready for anything out there. After all, this could very well be it.
Yeah, we're fine. You go be with Alicia, boss. She needs you real bad right now.
All right. You all know what you're doing.
But does he? This is a tough one. Even for Nature Boy.
Having Alicia and the boss moping around is a drag for the whole squad. I hope for everyone's sake they can pull out of this funk real soon.
Alicia, there you are. What's up?
Look at this, Welkin. Guess what? I found some lion's paw growing while I was out on my walk. Here you go. Very sharp. Makes you look like a real gentleman.
Well, thank you.
Welkin. They said it was Valdio. Is it true?
Afraid so.
Then when I walked through camp before, some of them got down on their knees, like they were worshiping me. Praise the Valkyria. The godchild. They were begging me to save Gallia. Me. I mean, what am I supposed to say to that?
Alicia, I...
What kind of life can I live from now on?
I wish I knew.
Wow, I'm sorry. Guess that was pretty heavy. Here we are right before the last battle, and I'm not helping things one little bit. Don't worry about me. Sergeant Alicia Melchiot, sir. Reporting. And ready for duty. My mind is focused on the mission. See you later, boss.
Alicia.
Oh, Alicia, don't worry. You were already the most powerful unit in the entire squad, and this squad is already the most powerful thing, supposedly, of the entire army, because we're single-handedly turning around the entire war, which basically means that you're the most effective soldier in the entire Gallian army before your Valkyr power is unlocked. So, you know, confidence! Fight for Ghirlandaio. Ghirlandaio.
Here is your mission brief.
The enemy is braced and waiting for our attack on the Citadel of Ghirlandaio. Before we can storm the palace, or the place, we need to pry off the lid. We'll blow in the front gates. The plan, as it stands, is to roll a car loaded with explosives up to a gate and detonate it. Your objective is to trip the three switches located along the rail. The switches' locations are as you see here. You'll have to push your way forward and hit each one in turn as you go. To activate each switch, approach it in action mode and press the A button, nice and easy. They'll be bearing down on you while with the Citadel's cannons, among other things. I also advise you to watch for mines. It's time to put everything you've learned in your missions. Everything you've learned in your missions so far to work on kicking these imps out of Gallia for good. I don't know, I completely tripped up on that one somehow. Alright, flip all three switches and you instantly win. No capturing a base, no defeating units, just flip the three switches and it's over. Alright, don't die, don't take 20 turns, don't let them take our base. Interesting. It makes no mention of a train car that's moving forward. I thought we were going to have to be racing ahead of a train car and outpacing it to flip all the switches, and that if it reached an unflipped switch, we would lose. But there's no mention of that here, so maybe that's not a thing. Okay. It's kind of like just capturing three bases, basically. Except instead of capturing three bases, you probably don't have to get rid of nearby enemies to flip switches. Alright. I might be going a little heavy, because, I don't know if there's more bases to capture along the way, so if that's the case, it's often a mistake to deploy too many people, because you can make characters appear up there instead. But, as often the case, the map's not super useful for determining that kind of information, so it's more like the kind of thing I would know if I replayed the mission. So we're going pretty heavy, because I have two shock troopers, two scouts, one of everything else, two tanks, because that part's mandatory, taking us up to 9 out of 10. We'll see how it goes. At the very least, all the people that give me CP are there. And if I can just forget somebody that will be in the background, it won't be such a big deal.
There are three switches total. Let's clear the way. Squad 7, move out!
Alright, all you can really see on the map is that there's a rail. So hopefully going in...
Foot soldiers, mortars, tanks, you name it, they'll be sending it all at us. Stay calm and just get from switch to switch. All right, soldiers, move out!
Hopefully once it's taken control of a character, I'll have a nice idea of what we're getting ourselves into. So switch number one, switch number two and three, they're both inside of a base, interestingly enough. That seems to be a bridge going past a moat with a bunch of cliffs on it. That's a Gatling bunker. Okay, I thought it was a mortar. There's a cannon bunker. Okay. So we'll probably want to use smoke when I get to that point of the challenge. Those are both bases up there. Yeah, there's actually a series of bases all along the path. Huh. In that case, it probably makes the most sense to try to summon people once I'm already up there. So I might have some people retreat, but you never know who will come in handy necessarily right off the bat, so I might as well get in there. I'll move forward with the Edelweiss first. It often just makes the most sense to use them because, he's a durable one. Oh, wow. Not the biggest map, is it? It's one of that there's no indication of a train behind me. It's one of those reoccurring things where when you look at the map, it looks absolutely massive, but then you see it in person, you're like, oh yeah! The freaking... Like, that's like a one turn as a scout away is the first switch. Just right up there, like it's no big deal. It's always a surprise to me. Howdy, folks. That is, in fact, a Lancer. Alright. Actually, can I just shoot you to death really easily? Shots to kill? Not enough. Not even if I aim for the head? Nah, headshots don't really exist right now, do they? Let's obliterate you. Oh. I goofed pretty hard, didn't I? Well, that happened. I forgot to select him directly. I just hit his general air with the explosive, so it did almost negligible damage, actually. That is an enemy tank! That looks like a good reason to have my allied engineer run up right behind me. Is that a Gatling gun? That is a Gatling gun. I see you. You're not just a soldier. Boom! Oh, really? That's a surprise. I just thought for sure that it would, I thought for sure that the Gatling gun would, get destroyed, or he'd get knocked off it. Not necessarily a full kill, but I thought he'd fall off the gun. I'm just gonna go, now that I know this tank's here, I'm just gonna go ahead and take care of that problem right away. Come on. Just a little more rotating. Just trying to face away from that Lancer if I can. Hey, buddy. Bye, tank. Look at that guy over there. They're all over the place. Alright, there's all sorts of stuff over there. Don't necessarily know how much danger I'm in some cases. But I'm still gonna use the tank again. Let's see here. What's my chance with the machine gun to just take this guy out? Just two shots to the head. Oh, okay. Gotcha. Well, I made a mess of things over here, didn't I? Ha ha ha. Just use him 50 times, whatever. They're not gonna stop me. You gonna stop me? You're not gonna stop shit. You're dead. Everyone's dead. I'm a tank. This is what happens when you let the player use the tank like 6 times in a row in a turn. They do this over and over again until everything's dead. The end. Don't know if there's any more. So that's where I can't use the tank anymore, because there's a bunch of that stuff going on over there. But that's just a shot. Those are troopers. They're usually bad at killing tanks. So if I just face this general direction, that'll be good for me. Alrighty, Alicia. Let's get you busy. I figure in a couple of turns he can cause some serious damage to these guys, especially since this guy is now turned around to look at the tank. So I can just pretty much run right up over there. Hi! It is nice to meet you, sir. My favorite part of you is how I'm never gonna see you again. The end. Bye.
What? My wounds are healing.
Mysterious body. Alright, I'm a Valkyr. I'm a crazy mutant person. Alright. Capture this first one. Hopefully it doesn't trigger some sort of crazy story event where 15 tanks come in to attack me.
Okay, that's the first switch down. Keep it up, Sevens.
Oh, seems done. The worrying thing about doing an objective in this game is you never know when you'll grab the objective and then immediately something horrible will happen that's really bad for your team. Welp, that's me immediately having access to a new place to spawn people. Don't I feel silly? Can I make it to the cover? I sure can. Alright. That'll help me against that guy at least. Actually, am I likely to be attacked from behind? That is an enemy tank. Yeah, maybe I'm safer over here. Resist crossfire? What crossfire am I resisting? Oh, there it is. There it is. Found it. Let's see. I'll face that way to shoot at him if he comes after me. But mostly I just want to be behind the cover to help me with the tank problem. Thankfully I'm facing the tank, so I don't have to worry about getting shot. Oh, is that the tank? I guess spatially that would be the bridge around here, so that would be the tank over there. Okay. Bit of a surprise. Wow, we are already up there, huh? Okay. it is tempting just to have people retreat so they show up there next. I'll have Juno move forward because she can. As another scout, she can reach all the way up there pretty quickly. It'll be interesting to see what I do with all the other characters. I didn't expect to have another camp that quickly. And just have that kind of progress instantly. What's that? Heavy Gatling. There's dangerous stuff over there. Getting over here is safer, for sure. Because it's most of the stuff's out of line. Said, that's another tank. That sure is another tank. Let's go over behind this real quick. It's fine. It's just there's a lot of tanks. Matt's the cleaner. I'm sure he's friendly. I mean, he's called the cleaner. How bad could he be? I'm doomed. So yeah, I kind of wish I hadn't summoned all those guys. That might have been a mistake. Because of all things, I didn't expect to have a new base that's twice as close to the rest of my objectives in the first turn. The tanks could be a problem. I want to get an engineer up there pretty quickly. Because our Edelweiss is going to be taking damage. And he can't cross all of those mines. I could technically disarm mines with my engineer, and relatively quickly. Ow. Because there's no limit on how many mines they can disable per turn. They just have to be able to move there. But it's no small deal. That's your whole turn, huh? Okay. Here comes enemy. They're shooting their own base again. What goes on in the head of these freaking AI? I'm not even in their base. I haven't crossed the bridge. They're just bombarding their own base for no reason. That's insane behavior. Alright, so there's a tank over here. Second tank over here. They both have... Let's see. My character's 26 hit points. They have 25 and 19. So I have a bit of an edge design-wise. I'm a bit stronger than they are. At least that's my basic reference points. There is a sniper on top of the wall. So moving Marina forward's not a terrible idea. And I do have to worry about what's in line of sight of people. Let's see here. Let's grab Marina. I'm gonna have her retreat. Can I see the enemy? I cannot. If I could see the enemy scout over there, I was gonna shoot them with Marina, but I can't really. See, the Shamrock has good movement, so he can just move right on up and help out and be the disposable tank that he is, because the Shamrock going down has no impact on the mission. He probably gives me CP. So I'd lose that, I suppose. See, there's at least one sniper up on that wall. Huh. Kind of thought I'd go further than that for some reason. Any good targets for my free shot that I can't lose that on? I know, I'll snipe that sniper with counter-sniping. It'll work out fine. This is a reasonable thing to try. I kind of wonder... Can I take out mines? I don't think I can aim at them properly from here. Maybe I shoot an anti-armor round at the mines. We'll see if they go up or not. Nope, that seemed like it would have hit the mine. And it did not explode. Can confirm. Nadine... I cannot hear the name Nadine without thinking about the Plinkett reviews, Star Wars Episode 3. The name is burned into my brain now. There's no escape. Come on, Nadine! Oh! Did I make it? If I hit A... Oh, it's the sandbags. I might as well. Ta-da! Now I'm safe. Don't you believe me? Alright. I'll give it another go. We're right up on this guy this time. So we'll go for the heal. Just keep him topped off. I mean, it's free, aside from the CP for using the character. But I also intend on doing this. Ta-da! The tough thing is that Nadine's probably not going to be safe after this. Probably gonna get shot pretty hard because she'll probably be in the open unless I specifically tell her to run away. I'll probably just commit to... Oh, wait.
We can't continue the advance until we clear this area.
Oh, I can't shoot... I can't break those the tanks, can I? Crap. I forgot, I don't think I can break the weird caltrop monster things. Forgot what they're called exactly. Can I get you to cover? Oh, that's just agony now. I don't want her to die. So I can't get him through. Maybe Alicia should go scouting. There's a sniper roost up there. Got some side flanks. This is not the area under fire right now. Something near that is what's under fire. The problem here is the sniper, of course. I'll scout a little more. Just because I can, but I'll probably want to run back. I'm probably not safe here. Hi. Sure would like to have a tank nearby. By which I mean a Lancer. I'll try shooting its weak spot, but I don't think it works out that way. Oh, nope. Tiny amount of tread damage. It's right on the radiator, but it does not at all affect the anything else. Well, Alicia's completely healed, so at least there's that. Because she's a magical, impossible Valkyr. Hello. Who's got a trench? Now that could be useful. I'm trying to press that button. I might be able to reach it through a trench. Take it slow, because I already fired once, so I can't fire on anyone I see. If I do this right, I might be able to escape the line of sight of the sniper. Am I in the danger zone yet? Not yet. It's up ahead, though. Resist crossfire. That means he's about to shoot me, so let's run away. Oh. Let's see what we can get done here.
My turn, okay?
Yeah, so that next leg of the trench is what's in danger. Aha! Ow. So much for resisting crossfire. There we go. She's invincible because she can't actually die, so I'm willing to gamble this a bit, see what happens. That next leg is what's in danger. Let's get past that part. Things are looking kind of safe around here, honestly. Can I crouch? Should be able to crouch right here. Oh, yeah. Is anyone looking at me right now? Not really. Sneaky, 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 sneaky. Activate. I'm in the middle of their base.
That's two switches. Just one left to go.
Oh, that's fascinatingly dumb. I love this game. It's so stupid. Alright, I'm just standing in the middle of their base. Alright, so the next switch is past that door, I believe. There's not one over here, is there? That's the one I flipped last. So the next one should be right past that gate. I very much doubt that I can open said gate. So I'm probably going to want to head right back. The way we came. Could just crouch here. I already fired, so I can't do anything else this turn. As tempting it is to try to take out the turret or something. I wish I could see clearly what the map looks like. Somewhere over right... I'll keep going. Somewhere over there is my goal. I can give her one more command to go a little further. Get past that danger zone. Our next goal's right there.
My turn, okay?
Probably won't get there this turn because of the diminishing return element of how her health works. Probably want to stay like right around here. Because right now I'm not in line of sight of any of the bad guys. I figure this is the most likely direction for them to attack me from, so I should face this direction. We'll heal up. So I'll face this direction for interception fire. And We'll see if she can just literally run into the base and grab the next one next turn. The Gatling turrets are probably going to be a problem. Although if I can capture this thing, I might be able to just summon a series of units over there too. Let's see, the next thing to do is probably just to bring the Edelweiss over there, right? It's not getting much done around here. Might as well just take it elsewhere. I'm going on a trip. I'm not just using the Edelweiss for shits and giggles either. If I get the Edelweiss over there, the specific benefit is that I might be in range to fire off smoke grenades. Which could mean being able to help Alicia's invasion. This might just be the Alicia and Welkin show for this fight. I might just ignore the rest of my party for the rest of this mission if I can pull this off. Alright, I just need one carefully... I need one carefully aimed smoke grenade somewhere at the bad guys. Might as well take a pot shot at this guy's end point to see if I get a one-shot kill. I did. That just happened. I just one-shot their tank. Shouldn't be in danger of lancers. We'll see how it goes. At least you could just get shot to death, like, right now. Which would complicate the matter of me trying to use her for this purpose. And then I'd have to risk... I'd either have to wait for her to come back or try using someone like Juno, but Juno would be at risk of getting destroyed permanently. I wonder how many people are even going to use turns this turn. Oh. Well, that's not good. He's right behind me, although he doesn't seem to be very interested in Alicia. So, have fun, random scout. Is he going to shoot... Oh, wow. Range. Also, by killing that tank, I made things safer for my engineer, because she's kind of behind the wall. She's not really safe, but she's behind the wall, so the tank that's currently alive is less likely to be able to shoot her, unless it does a lot of maneuvering. But the tank that I just killed could have just shot straight across at her. But I had a really lucky radiator shot, apparently. Alright, I should probably start this turn by using the Edelweiss to shoot that guy in the face, and then move forward a bit, and go from there. Here's another concern. Because we're back in the realm of story missions, there's a very real risk that the game might just be like, nah, this is the objective now, midway through the mission. Kind of like the time where it's like, oh, take care of this problem. Surprise, there's a tank now. Surprise, there's a Valkyrie now. And like sometimes there's been a few missions where the objective changes over and over again. So if that happens, I could be in trouble. I should be angled in the right direction where he can't hit my weak spot. So he just has to do some body damage. And unless he uses the same tank four times a turn, he's not likely to be able to do that. Oh, there he goes, doing that. Alright. That's what I get for using that sentence. Still, I'll be around the corner soon. Well, that was a mistake on your part. There's one for Nadine. The engineer that ran across the entire map. Repaired a sandbag for no reason, repaired the Edelweiss very slightly, and then disarmed some mines that I realized that I don't have any use for disarming, and then stood in the open. not my most ingenious move, admittedly. Alright, it'll be interesting to see if this works out. What are you shooting? What are you shooting? What are you shooting? There's a tank in your base. There's an enemy tank inside your base and you're not going to target them? Weird. Weird. Like, I understand on a conceptual level that, like, that these mortars, they just don't have AI. They just shoot somewhere. They have, like, a list of locations they'll shoot and they just pick one. I don't know if it's random or if they cycle through them in a specific order or what, but I understand the concept that they're just like, they're just kind of doing whatever they feel like. But it's still baffling to watch in real time. Hey friend, I'm gonna shoot you in your face, like real hard. Maybe I'll use the mag. Is that more likely to kill? Good old headshots. There we go. Now here's a question, can I squeeze past that mine? Because I think the answer is no. But let's find out for fun. Oh, this is dangerous. This is a terrible idea. Well, Well, now I'm definitely touching it, so now I'm definitely screwed. Wait. Are those human mines? That's an anti-personnel mine, isn't it? Nope, it's not. Nope, it was a me mine. That was me being a dummy. Alright. It happens. Oh, look at our tank. Can I not move? Hostile sighted. Take that. I just ran over a human body. With a freaking goddamn tank. It's like mulching a human being with your body. I don't know how well I rank the chance of success here, honestly. Gonna want to smoke that, Oh, there's also mines over there, just to add to the pile, huh? And there's a Gatling turret. There's risks here. And I also have to use the Edelweiss more than once, because of the whole smoke grenade, because I already attacked. Isara, smoke! Alright. Just gonna put this right in front of you. There we go. That ought to help. And... yeah, I think that'll work. And I should have a lot of CP to spend, so let's go ahead and spend orders to help with their defense chance. Restore everyone's health. Attack somebody, accuracy, all allies' defense. Caution. Resistance to interception fire. There we go. She should only need 1 to 3 commands to move her. I mean, CP to move. So I could spend all sorts of CP just buffing her up. So now she's less likely to get killed by interception fire. Next time we'll just want to increase her defense. Just in general. I don't think evasion helps. I'm pretty sure evasion is what happens when it's the enemy's turn and they shoot you and then you duck. So I don't have a reason to boost that. So reviewing our targets, those are cannon towers. These are the problem, they're Gatling bunkers, so I have to move fast to avoid getting killed by those quickly. That's relying somewhat heavily on the idea of the boost I just got. I'll try to hide behind our tank a little bit, go in the smoke. We have to be very careful not to get killed by the mines that are over here. There we go. Go, 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 go. Yeah. We got your gates open. Here comes the bomb train.
Yes! We've hit all three of the switches!
Excellent job, Lieutenant Gunther. All right. We're sending the explosives down. Once we blow the gate, we'll storm in.
Yes, Captain.
I was slightly afraid it was not going to say operation complete, and instead the mission was going to continue because a new objective pops up, and then everyone shoots her in the face.
Operation complete. The road's open, Sevens.
Ta-da! A rank. That's actually a rare example of a mission where it felt like it made sense in story for Alicia to, like, kamikaze her way straight to the objective and grab it. Because usually it's like an enemy base, and you gotta capture the enemy base, and it's like, really? Some scout grabbed a flag and they win? This is stupid. Like, it's just like, it's a video game, so you accept it, but, like, it doesn't make sense, and it's kind of unsatisfying, so it's kind of fun just to go and fight your way forward the whole way. But this specific case, we're literally just flipping a switch so a train will crash into their base, so... that's actually, like, the perfect narrative situation for a scout to just go charging in, flip a switch, and risk everything, but risk as few soldiers as possible. So that was actually satisfying to do that way. That was a nice change of pace. Got a new medal waiting for us, and a lot of experience to spend.
Great! There's a clear path to the Citadel!
Proud warriors of Gallia! I must commend you. You have breached Ghirlandaio's gates.
Look up there, the Valkyria.
We meet again. It looks like fate is toying with us.
You have already defeated me once, as a Valkyria. Still, I have come to fight you again. It's a matter of pride. But this time, I will face you as a woman. This will be our last time, then. One of us is going to die here. Now, we fight!
Well,
time for a big final showdown against Selvaria, it appears. We'll be going straight into a fight at the beginning of the next episode. Don't even need a cutscene for it.